I think when Tomer and my agent first expressed the idea of this possibility, the first thing I wanted to do was talk to them about it. I wanted to kind of explain why I was so excited about it. It wasn't just that it was Jake Heggie and this new work and working with Tomer and being in Atlanta, but it was also because my own connection to the Polish culture, because I'm married to a Polish person. And first generation, he came over to go to college. He's kind of, you know, the American dream. And his family is still in Poland. And, you know, just hearing his stories of growing up in communism, hearing the stories of my father-in-law, his dad, who was, you know, a child during the war, and the things that they had to do to survive. I mean, I could go on forever with the stories. I mean, they're so fascinating to me, and they just conjure this sense of kind of not being able to describe it, because it's just so hard to imagine. Her name is Krystyna Żywulska. It was brought up the other day in a discussion, as you had said, you know, this was a collaboration, people offering their insights, and someone had asked, you know, why this little group of women, you know, why were they always together? But I think it's important to remember that these women knew Krysia's secret, that she was a Jew and that she had changed her name at the moment she was caught. So that she could be a prisoner of war. Rather than expose the secret, they were her confidants, and they kept the secret, and they looked up to her because of this line of connection with her poetry and how it was uplifting to them. I think it's even more poignant in the story to know how difficult that was for Krystyna to live with in, you know, afterwards, knowing that she was the survivor based on what she needed to do and did do to survive. I love how Krystyna says, "There are no words." I was haunted by that as I was learning the score, because as I told you, even with my connection to my husband and his family, I mean, at times there just aren't words really to describe certain things that happen in our world. And I think people will walk away not really being able to put it into words. They will be so profoundly affected by this, in, I think, the best sense of affected. But obviously it'll, you know, cause tears, it'll cause, you know, reverie, deep thought. But in all of that, I think it will be this phenomenal sense of, how do I express what I just experienced, which is incredible.